Boys, you read the title correctly. Today, I'm going to be showcasing to you a brand new move in the Strongest Battlegrounds that hardly anybody knows about. And guys, this move is pretty easy to do, and it got added not in the most recent update that you're thinking of, but in an update after the update. Let me just show you. So here we go. I'm in the update log for the Strongest Battlegrounds. As you can see, this is the big most recent update. But now if I scroll down, as you can see, we got Seismic Fist being changed, all this stuff, right? But if I'm not mistaken, somewhere in here. Okay, wait, actually, no, I guess they removed it. Okay, guys, well, basically, they added Black Flash to the game. It's a move that you can do on your opponents whenever you perfect block them. And I guarantee half the people watching this video right now are thinking, you can perfect block? Yeah, you can perfect block in the Strongest Battlegrounds. I didn't know about it until recently either. But yeah, guys, right here, I have my alt account. So here's what I'm gonna do. Basically, I'm just gonna showcase a perfect block. So as you can see, I'm gonna have my alt hit me and then perfectly block. And as you can see, that did 10% of the opponent's health. Regular M1s do 3 to 4% of the opponent's health. Now, you can only do this on real players, so no practicing on test dummies. But as you can see, if I do 4 M1s, it's just a little bit over 10%. The equivalent of one perfect hit is 3 M1s. So yeah, that's pretty cool. And this is a great combo starter, because as you can see, the final 3 M1s do 11% health. So if you have the first M1 do 10% of the health, that means just with M1s, you're already able to do 21% of your opponent's health just if you land this. But you might be thinking, that's not Black Flash. And you'd be right, you win a gold star, it is not Black Flash. Yet. Let me explain. Basically, sometimes, if you can hit your perfect block exactly at the right time, it will do this. Okay, not that. I messed it up. Hang on. It will do this. No, okay, didn't do it. It will do this. Oh my gosh. Ahem. This. This. Oh my gosh. I did it like 3 times in a row earlier. Hang on. There we go, there we go, there we go. I did it. Now, guys, that move does a lot of damage. Honestly, I don't know how much damage exactly, but I know it gives you a ton of ultimate too. So if you look at my ultimate bar, I really don't have anything down there right now. But yeah, as you can see, it does quite a bit more. I think it does like twice as much damage. So if I'm not mistaken, one of these hits does 20% damage. Now, guys, there's been a lot of controversy in the community over if this move is just random chance or if this move is executed. Gosh, I can't talk. Like due to perfect timing. And I know that this is something that even Holy Grail was wondering about. But guys, today I actually messaged the owner and asked. And as you can see right here, the owner confirmed that it is due to perfect timing. So if you can get really good at timing your M1s just right and timing your block just right, then you can consistently hit this move. See if I can do it again. No? Okay. Well, oh, there we go. Now, guys, here is why this is so useful. And it's because this is gonna be such like a revolutionary thing for combos. There's so many different pieces of tech that are just not very consistent. Let me try and think of one. Oh yeah, for example, M1 uppercut tech, that. Here, let me see if I can do it. Boom, uppercut, and then M1. Yeah, see, it didn't work that time. But there's essentially a chance when doing an uppercut that if your opponent has low enough ping, then when you uppercut and you M1, it'll do more damage, and it's a really great tech for starting into combos and stuff. But as you see there, it's super inconsistent. With this, if you learn and you get good, it's going to be completely consistent 100% of the time. So I know I'm going to be doing a lot of practicing with this, just trying to see. Oh, there we go. I did it. I don't know if it's the timing of your M1 or if it's the timing of the block that counts. Maybe it's both. Let me know in the comments if you can find that out. But yeah, as you can see, just by doing a couple M1s, I've already got my ultimate. Also, another thing that you can do is right after you hit that perfect M1, you can dash and it'll send your opponent flying back. Here, let me see if I can do it in order. So the opponent's gonna hit and then, oh, nope, I was too late. Opponent hits, I block, and then, oh, nope, wrong button. My bad. Boom. No. Oh my gosh. How did I do it twice in a row? Here we go. M1, block, M1, and I was too late with the dash. Okay, one more time, one more time. Boom, 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 boom. There we go. Now, I did actually hit a perfect block there. And you might be wondering, how do I know when I hit just a normal perfect block? Because there is a difference between Black Fist and perfect block and just a normal M1. Normal M1s are just gonna do 12% of your opponent's health if you do all 4 of them. A single M1 does 3 to 4% of the opponent's health. A perfect block does 10% of the opponent's health. So what you gotta do for that is literally just block at the right time and then punch. M1, block, punch. You'll know if you hit it correctly if you hear like a glass breaking sound effect. Oh, never mind. They changed it. At least I think they did. It's more of like a rib breaking sound effect now. So listen again. Here it is one more time. And then just for reference, this is what a normal M1 sounds like. And then one more time, a perfect block. So yeah, guys, now you know when you hit a black flash or perfect block, you'll know what it sounds like based on how it sounds. But yeah, this is super useful, especially if you can get consistent at it. And just perfect blocking, not even doing the black flash like I just did, just perfect blocking is already gonna do so much more damage. You're literally doing 3 times more damage just with a perfect block. And I believe black flash does 20% damage, which that is a lot of health. Boom. So yeah, guys, this move is pretty crazy. Oh, also, guys, you'll probably notice that I don't have my camera on. I'm trying out going back to my old style of videos without the camera, just because it sounds better and it's so much easier to record and edit, so this video will be way easier to actually produce. I'll still wear the mask and glasses and live streams and shorts and stuff, but for the time being, I plan on keeping the camera off in my videos. Don't be mad, you literally voted for this. Yesterday, I asked you guys, and the result was an overwhelming yes. So my bad, I didn't know you guys didn't like the camera that much. So here I am switching back to the way things used to be. So that's really exciting. I do have a lot planned ahead for what to do with the mask and sunglasses and stuff. I'm currently working on the plans for that, trying to see how to budget it and stuff, because the plans that I have for it would be very expensive. But I'll keep you guys posted on how that goes, because I've got some pretty crazy plans, but I don't want to say them just yet, because I'm not sure if I'll be able to actually pull through with them. Hold up, let me join up in a public server and see if I can land one of these. And then we'll just talk. Dude, I have not been uploading much recently. I mean, I'm back on the grind now, baby. And yeah, I don't know. Let's just catch up. So without further ado, I'm gonna join up in a public server. I'll see you guys there. All right, here we go. I'm in a public server. I'm gonna get Ryan the Great real quick to join. I'm just waiting to see that ranked number one in S class join. Bro, why is this man? Oh my gosh, bro. I think I just hit him with a crit as well, actually. Bro, this guy is terrible at the game. I'm not gonna lie. 1, 2, 3. Uppercut. I'm gonna normal punch him just like that. Oh, yep. S-class ranked number one. Ryan is in the game. Also, the guy that I was just fighting literally just left mid-fight. He left the server. Bro is not having it. All right, so for those of you that don't know, Ryan the Great is currently number 2 on the all-time leaderboard, and he's currently number 1 on the like monthly leaderboard or whatever. Oh, okay, this guy just tried beating me up, so Ryan's got me covered. Oh my gosh, dude, Ryan is cracked. Metal Bat Ultimate? Yeah, right. Bro, there's no way. Oh my gosh, my man just tried using a move, and Ryan said, nuh-uh. Oh, hold up, Ryan, I'll save you. Never mind, I'm not saving you. This is bad. I feel like I shouldn't even help. Ryan's just got me covered, bro. Hold up. This guy, all of his moves are on cooldown now. So here we go. I'm gonna uppercut him just like that. Boom, forward dash, down slam. Oh, never mind. This is bad. We're also in the middle of the map, so we're about to get third partied, I swear. Yo, this guy's trying to third party, bro. Get down, buddy. Get down. 1, 2, 3, normal punch, you're dead. Yes, sir. But yeah, guys, I had a lot of fun recording this video. Shout out to Ryan for joining up and teaming with me. Let me know what you think of the new black flash move in the comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you again very soon. Peace.